Hello and good morning, friends. Welcome to the CEC EduSec Live Lecture. Dear friends, today in this session, we would be talking on information communication technology in rural development. We would be going to understand how information communication technology is helpful in rural development. And to give answer to this question, we have once again with us in our studios, Professor Divesh Kishore. Professor Divesh Kishore is a Professor Emeritus, Makhanlal Chaturvedi, National University of Journalism and Communication. So let's welcome Professor Divesh Kishore and let's try to understand how, after all, information communication technology would be helpful in rural development. Hello, sir. Welcome to EduSec Lecture.
Thank you very much. Today we will be having discussion on role of ICTs in rural development. I think the first thing we must try to understand, what do we mean by ICT? That is information communication technologies. There is a lot of confusion on this terminology of ICT amongst the people. I think we should have a clear understanding and perception that these three words, information, communication, technology, all these three words are interrelated in which way and they will make it useful. Let's go to the meaning of international communication, information technology and their role in the development process. Actually, ICT means information processing. Information processing means how do we take the knowledge and process it so that the receiver is able to get it and understand it. That means we have to use certain communication devices and the softwares to convert that information into a intelligible information which could be understood. Therefore, the technologies which have to be used is to convert, store, protect, process, transmit and retrieve the information. I think you must remember the ICT has got multiple role to play and responsibilities through which we can make the information intelligible for the receivers. So there are three words which are involved in information communication technology. I think let us understand first word, which is information. Information is what? Information related to the innovations, to the knowledge which we want to pass it on to the receiver or to the user. That what we mean by information. And the second word is communication. Here communication is related with the devices, channels, methodology. How can we transmit those information to the users by using language, symbols, signs, or whatever methodology which is understood by the users or the receivers. So therefore, the second important word in ICT is the communication. And third is technologies. Technology means the use of knowledge which you are communicating and resources which will helpful in accepting that particular information. So what are those technologies which we are trying to communicate? So information communication technology is made of three words, combination of three words, information, communication and technology. And these three words really make a meaning of taking the knowledge to the users, to their doorsteps. Therefore, we should be able to understand ICT in that respect. Actually, ICT, if we try to understand, it is a worldwide growth of electronic media, which is called information explosion. I think in this century, if any explosion has taken place, it is the information explosion. So much of information has come, readily available. You name it, it is there, and is available on a device which is very easy to handle. So therefore, this information explosion sometimes is also confusing. Sometimes it might be misunderstood. But we have to take in a right direction, and this information explosion have to be used for that particular purpose. So the media, which is the main communication device used in ICT, that is the real crux of the whole thing, which has the power to change the human behavior. Any media, whether it is a radio or television or newspaper or even social media, you name it, they are all being used to change the human behavior. Human behavior in three terms. Number one, in terms of knowledge. He doesn't have that knowledge, media has provided him the knowledge. The information has been provided by the media. The second thing is skill. He didn't know how to use it, and the media has provided how to use that particular tool or by that particular knowledge for the benefit of the society or of the individual. And third is attitude. His way of thinking has been modified by the media. So media plays three significant roles, that is, in changing the human behavior, which consists of three components. Number one is the attitude, number two is the skill, and number three is the knowledge. So knowledge, skill, and attitude are changed by the media, which has got a wonderful power to reach to the people. And therefore, communication experts call the media as a magic multiplier. Why magic multiplier? These media can go on multiplying the information at a very fast speed and deliver it to the users. Therefore, they are the magic multipliers. They can go on multiplying very fast. And then others, school of thought, others experts say that it is a lubricant in development process. So there are two important functions, magic multiplier and lubricator of the development process. It helps increasing the development process. Whether it's a rural development process, whether it's an urban development process, any development you take place, the media plays the role of magic multiplier and the lubricator. And media is the important part of the communication devices which are being used by the communicator, by the person who is an informer to the receivers. So therefore, information, communication, technologies, and whatever the technological skill he wants to impart, that is being given. So media, nowadays we have started using the social media. And therefore, the social media is also playing a very important role. Please remember, social media, amongst all the media, that is radio, television, newspaper, is the best source of interaction and also expression. If you want to express, if you want to give your reaction, you can just put it on the Facebook, on the Twitter, or whatever social media, and it will be spread. But that is not possible on radio, television, and newspaper, because they are controlled and they have different process of taking the information and delivering. Therefore, social media nowadays playing a very significant role, because the interactions, the component of interaction on both the sides is possible. If we try to see, analyze, overall, media has been playing a very significant role in the social, cultural, and economic development of the society. And in ICT, of course, the media ownership, access to media, these are the some of the important characteristics or points to be considered. Now, for example, a study has shown that the availability of social media to the population in the rural area is hardly about 1.5%. Now, if that media, social media is not available to the people, number one, they don't know how to use it, number two, there is no infrastructure, number three, if these are the impediments, then the media will not be that accessible and effective. In case of radio, in case of television, we find they are almost available everywhere, almost free of cost. Except newspaper, which is now also available in different languages to the people with a minimal cost. People are using it. So therefore, in ICT, media devices, whichever we are using, the communicator, the informer is using, will has to understand that what is the best media through which he can reach to the people and communicate his body of information. Now let us come to the another important aspect of this topic, is development. What do we mean by development? If we try to understand development, development means essentially maximizing the production and services available to the people. If we say agricultural development, it means we want to increase the agricultural production to a maximum level. If we are saying educational development, that means we are trying to say that facilities, infrastructure are made available, services are made available, so that there is a significant increase in the education level of the people. So development actually is a common word. It can be attached to any services, and that has got the meaning into it. So therefore, in our case, when we talk of the rural development, then we are concerned with the development of the rural society, where lot of issues related to development have to be tackled down. So therefore, now the question is that have we understood really the crux of the or the meaning of the development itself? I have tried to find out from the International Encyclopedia how do they define the development. They say development is a purposive change undertaken in a society to achieve what may be regarded generally as a different, improved state of social and economic affairs. Now here in this definition, which is given in International Encyclopedia, that says purposive changes. What changes which you would like to bring is a purposive, intentional, is not unintentional changes. So therefore, you will, in person who is trying to bring the change, he will bring those changes which are positive in nature, which will really help the society, which will help the individuals. So the purposive changes, development means the purposive changes taken by the, brought by the informer, that has to be taken care of. So the notion here is the basically related to development communication. How we use communication for the development of the society. Here I am talking of the rural society, giving the examples of the rural areas. How can we make use of it? We have two very famous communication experts. You must have heard of their names, Mr. Rogers and Shoemaker. They brought a different definition of development. They say that development is a tool which brings the social change in the society in order to produce higher per capita income and levels of living through modern production methods. What is their emphasis? Their emphasis is if per capita income of the people increased, then that is a desirable change. That means if his income level is increased, he will have more spending powers. When he can spend more, he will definitely improve his standard of living. So that will ultimately increase the whole power of the society. So that is why he said development is the modernization at the social system level. So they have gone to the extent that if development takes place, the modernization of the rural area also changes. Their way of living, their way of thinking, their way of acting, all that brings change into the whole society itself. Now let us emphasize and understand what development communication actually we mean in the context of our country. We say that development communication are the organized efforts to use the communication process and media to bring social, cultural, economic improvement of an individual, society or nation. So we are using the information here through communication devices so that there is a change in the society or the individuals. And that will ultimately improve their quality of life. Because quality of life is basically governed by the economic resources individual or society has. The richer the society, it is assumed the better modern quality of life, facilities he will have. Let us not compare it with the social value system, but let us compare it with the modernization. Because value system might get reduced. There is a different aspect of it. But here what we are saying, in terms of economic development, social development and cultural development, that definitely increases because of the economic resources made available to them. There is another famous communication expert in Philippines, Nora C. Cubrel. She said that actually development communication can be called as an art and science of human communication applied to speedy information and transformation of a country and the masses of the people from poverty to a dynamic state of economic growth that makes it possible for social equality and larger fulfillment of human potentials. Let us see, analyze this definition. Here the emphasis is that development communication in which we are using ICTs is both art and science. When we say art and science, it means there is a scientific reason behind it, or reasons behind it, and there is a methodology how to take this information to the people. And for what? A speedy transformation of the country. If you are interested to bring the speedy transformation in the individuals, in the groups, in the society, then you are using ICTs. And then it will help to their economic growth, which will ultimately help in improving the quality of life. So in other words, that is the development communication. Now we have understood what is information, what is communication, and what is technologies. We have also understood now what is development communication. Next question is, what is the role of ICTs in development communication? What roles it can play? And as a user, what can we do? Now it has been found that it has a great potential in taking knowledge and information to the rural population. This is a quotation by Dr. M.S. Swaminathan, who is father of Green Revolution in this country, a great agriculture scientist. And he has proved that ICTs have really helped the rural population in getting the knowledge and information and using it for their development. Therefore, ICTs have those potentials which can be used for harnessing for the use of the rural people. Now, let us consider what are those potentials of these new technologies and global networks too. Number one, creates economic opportunity. I think we will all agree on this point. When you communicate the information, knowledge, skill to the people, they become more knowledgeable and skilled. What is happening today in our country that we do not have skilled people? We have number of youth who are there. They are unemployed. But if they learn the skill, let's say a very simple thing. If they learn driving, they can become drivers. If they learn how to operate X-ray machines, they become X-ray technicians. What I am trying to say is the skill which is lacking on their part. And if this skill is imparted, then that real problem can be solved to a great extent. The present government, central government, has taken up this task at a very high level. They want to train people now. A number of centers have been opened all over the country where school drops out are those who have passed high school and intermediate, could not go for higher studies. They can go for 6 months, 4 months, 1 year programs which are skill based. And after getting a training of 6 months, 1 year, whatever the period is, they can be useful to the society. Now that is what is required. So number one, it has a potential of creating economic opportunities and also providing training to the people in a very easy manner. You can use any media. You can use radio, you can use television, you can use social media. You might have heard and read in the newspaper. Some people have developed even the smaller bombs by just reading and going through the text in internet, through internet. What a great thing. Even the open universities and open schooling are able to provide skills to the students in addition to the knowledge about a particular phenomena or discipline. So it has that potential, that advantage that can be done. Third advantage is that government can use it to a great extent. Of course, only in case of social media, we do not have the infrastructure available in rural areas. But as far as the other media is concerned, like radio and television, they are all reaching. Why can't we start technical programs, skill-based programs through this media? I think CEC is doing one wonderful job in imparting this information through television. So, ICT, these media devices can play a significant role. And they can give the convincing information and knowledge to the receivers. ICT in this sense has a great potential of communicating the information and changing the human behavior in terms of knowledge, skill and attitude, and that is possible through ICTs. Thank you. I discussed about the potentials of the ICT in rural development. And great potentials were mentioned by me that it creates a fast method of communication, of knowledge, skill, attitude to the receivers. And it can also show them, demonstrate them how a particular activity can be done. But let us not forget about the constants, because every good thing has limitations, has certain constant problems. Number one constants with the ICT is the cost. Cost of related to ICTs include the establishment and maintenance of reliable infrastructure. That is the biggest problem. Because in ICTs, whatever we are using, we find that the infrastructure is not easily available. Even nowadays we are discussing about Wi-Fi to be made available at different places. But in rural areas if you go, number one, the computers are not available, laptops are not available. Even if somebody has got it, then you find the problem of the electricity. Electricity is not available. So there are different important points which have to be considered before using ICTs at a very high speed. And that is why perhaps in this country, in our country, we have not been able to use ICTs up to that level. In case of social media, which is becoming very popular in different parts of the world, and everybody is using it. Here, we find it's very, very limited. That is, 2 or 3% of the population is able to use in rural areas. That is the first and foremost important limitation about the use of ICTs. Number two, its operation. Even if you made the infrastructure available, how many people are able to operate it? That means a basic fundamental training has to be provided who are going to use ICTs. That means you should have thousands and thousands of training centers or methods so that people can be trained how to use ICT for their benefit. So the second point is operation of the ICTs. We find there are phones are not available, then how do you connect it? That is a basic thing which should be available there. Of course, I mentioned about electric lines. Third important thing is regular maintenance and updating. That facility should be made available. If you do not have that facility, then how do you run your ICTs programs for the benefit of the people? I think these are the three most important problems, or I would say constants, associated with the ICT use. It has to be seen how we can overcome these problems. Efforts are being made by opening kiosks in each village run by a private person, where you will have the telephone connection, a laptop, a desktop computer available, a TV set. All those facilities will be available in a kiosk in a village and it will be on a very nominal charges it is made available. That is a good attempt. But how many kiosks we can establish where the trained persons are available? The other thing is, which is also another constant, are the cultural issues. When we say cultural issues, means the issues related with the social value system, cultural value system, and the problems of communication. So these are the some of the problems or constraints in use of ICTs. But after considering all these limitations, I think an appeal has to be made about ICTs. Appeal is that ICTs can have a stronger appeal than participatory process, which appears more complex to manage and requires closer interaction. That would mean, in other words, that ICTs can definitely increase the process of participation. They can give you reactions instantly. People can express by using social media. They can write their own stories. Even citizen journalism can be used at a greater speed by use of ICTs. You can put your own feature stories, articles, news items through various methods of social media. So therefore, the social media, which is almost uncontrolled, can be used without any expense or expenses to express yourself, which was not possible earlier. And therefore, ICTs in use can be increased tremendously. You must have been reading in the newspaper, viewing in the TV, listening to the radio. A small thing happens on one university campus, or one thing happens in the city. Through the use of these media, it spreads very fast from one corner to another corner, without any time, without any loss of time. Now, is this possible? And also people have started reacting to it, writing their own opinion, expressing their own views through social media. Whole media you will find if you go through the various, you will find they are all full. People are expressing wherever they are. So in that way, we should initiate and motivate people to use social media more and more so that they are able to express, they are able to participate in the process. Earlier it was a difficult process. Of course, we developed a Panchayati Raj system where we provided opportunity to the people to express themselves. But due to several problems that people are not able to use it as they should have done it. Therefore, that has not yielded the results which we wanted. But ICT can do it. If we take care of the constraints, as I mentioned it to you, if those constraints are taken up by the administration, by the country machinery, then definitely ICT use will increase and people will be able to participate. Now let us come to examine the impact of ICTs on society. There has been a great impact of ICTs on the society. Like new communication technologies such as satellite, cable television, wireless telephony, the internet, computers have brought a lot of changes in the society. We are able to get the information worldwide through satellite without loss of any time. Cable television gives us all the type of information as well as educational programs like DTH. Through DTH, free programs are available and the students can take the advantage of it. Even the other channels are also providing educational programs. Therefore, none of these students can say that it is difficult to get the educational material or educational lessons so that I can learn it. Now, they are all available through different sources. You can go to YouTube. You can go to educational programs or TV channels, whether they are private or government. You can go to various search engines and you can get the information. So therefore, these search engines have been very helpful. Nowadays, I wonder, sometime in my classes, I'm sure in other classes also, when I ask a question to the student calmly take out his mobile phone, use the internet, goes to search engine, Google, and get the answer, and tells me the answer of the question. How fast the student is able to get the information, which is not possible otherwise. Now that we potential we must understand, and that is what is the, it is creating the impact on the society. Of course, any good thing has advantages and disadvantages and limitations. Nowadays, because of these facilities are available, you find that the technology which students are using, it cut-paste technology, which is highly undesirable. If you use plagiarism, you will find plagiarism is as high as 70%, 80% in the assignments. That is not a good sign. So these are the limitations, or we would say disadvantages of ICT. Or the student is not reading, he is just going to search engine and give the answer of your question without understanding it. That is also a harmful impact. But it has got lot of advantages. Lot of advantages means that he can learn the whole skill, he can get the whole knowledge, he can get all the information within no time. Sitting anywhere, at any place, at any time, these are the biggest advantage. You need not to go to the classroom. You need not to go to the teacher at appointed time. Whenever convenient to you, whenever you want to get the information. You can go to the YouTube on that particular topic and you can get all the information or to search engines. So, I find another added dimension here. Added dimension is that these media also work as a interpersonal communication methods. Earlier, the mass media were only the mass media. They were not interpersonal. In the sense that if you want to get some clarification or doubts to be clarified, you may have to write them back, then they will answer after some time. So they were all mass communication methods. But now because of the social media, they are also interpersonal. You can just do the chatting. You can put your information, immediately you get the reply. Whether the person is sitting 5,000 miles away from you, it doesn't matter. The information is available to you. Answer is available to you. So therefore, this new media has a combination of interpersonal communication and mass communication. That is a very, very interesting thing, an important point, that we can use it as an interpersonal communication channel as well as mass communication channel. And we can also use as an interactive channel. Through emails, we can do it. So that is a great potential in the new media, in the social media, that they can be used as interactive channels, they can be used as mass communication channels, they can be used as interpersonal communication channels. Now, how can we empower farming community through use of ICTs? I have done a completed research study in the Himalayan region about the use of ICTs in empowering the farming community. This was conducted in 2010 and funded by Singapore Internet Research Center Asia in collaboration with Nanyang Technological University. And this is a project which was of 1 year duration, brought out certain facts in terms of our Himalayan region especially. Why Himalayan region we have taken up? Because Himalayan region doesn't have the infrastructure. They, as you know, in Himalayan region, the people live in different places on the hillocks, valleys. Sometimes it's very difficult to reach there. No modes of transport, no air links, no trains, no more travel road. You have to only walk. Now in those situations, how ICTs can help them? Because ICTs have a interesting way of handling the information and communication. So we find in this study that about 80% of the household had at least one prepaid mobile telephone connection. This is very interesting. That 80% of the people nowadays have telephone, even rural areas of hilly districts, which I thought may not be true, but it is true. Number two, television was found in 68% of the houses. And I asked them the question, how do that this television is so popular here? They said television is used for three things. Entertainment, education and information. We are sitting so far from the city, from the urban area, from other friends. We have no source. Television is very handy to us. And therefore, keeping these three functions, information, entertainment, and education, we have gone for the television. So about 70% of the people have TV with them. 80% people have the mobile phones, 70% people have the televisions. In case of radio, which I expected, many people will be, about 100% people will be having radio sets. But that is not true. Only 38% of the people have radio sets. This is a very interesting finding. Radio is very cheap, easily available, but only 38% of the household, 40% of the household were having the radio sets. Because I think over the television, radio doesn't have superiority. In television, we get a lot of entertainment, pictures and all that, which radio is not able to give them. So therefore, only about 38% people have the radio set. In case of newspaper, 24% of the people were subscribing newspaper. Those who are living nearer the city, they are able to get the newspaper. When we came to the computers with internet connection, we find only 1.5% of the households are having the computers. Now you see here, the number of people or household having internet is only 1.5%. ICT having so much of the tremendous potential, in spite of that, they don't have the internet or computer facilities with them. They have television, they have radio, may not be that amount of number, but the very poor is the, and this is what, when we further asked the question, the everybody answered, because of the lack of infrastructure. Here electricity doesn't come regularly, how we can use it? Or we don't have the towers here, we do not get the internet properly, or we do not know how to operate it, we don't have trained people for using this, or it is a very expensive medium. So all sorts of reasons were given. But mobile phones, about 80% people are having mobile phones connection. Then I think the information explosion, the main reason is the mobile telephones. And we can use mobile telephones for giving the information. We found that it was being used by the government machinery in Himalayan region to communicate information related to their development, especially agriculture development. They are using it. They are releasing the information through telephones, mobile phones, telling them about the new agricultural practices, telling them about the what is the new things which are happening, or even warnings that there is going to be hailstorm, save your crops, or some pest is going to attack, and what you should do, how should you save your crop from pests, like that. So that is free of cost. You ring up, this is our number. On this number, if you ask question, any question related to agriculture development, we'll answer you. Now, I think that is a right direction in which the mobile phones are being used for communicating the information. Let us go to the recommendations of National Commission. The National Commission on Farmers noted that knowledge deficit constraints of agriculture productivity is there. It added that use of information and communication technology for agricultural extension is one way of addressing information needs of the farmers. I think National Commission report has made it very clear that if you solve the problem of the farmers or the rural areas, it is the ICT. That is the only answer, because it works as an interpersonal medium of communication, it works as a group medium, mass medium of communication, and therefore it can address all the needs of the farmers. The working group which was appointed by the National Commission on Agricultural Extension, it has also in 11th plan itself indicated that we should have very strong group of ICTs, and also various state governments should take steps so that ICTs are made available along with the infrastructure to the people. With the help of ICTs, we will be able to communicate the information to the rural people or farmers who can maximize the production of agriculture. So that can be, is possible, and ultimately it is said that with the help of ICTs, agriculture extension is expected to become more diversified, knowledge intensive, demand driven, and thus more effective in meeting farmers' information needs. I think this is the crux, this is the whole summary of the things which National Commission on Farmers said, that if you want knowledge intensive to be given, and demand-driven, what they want, what information that is to be given, and effectively to meet their needs, it's only possible through ICT. And therefore, more and more impression has to be taken care of ICTs, and we should use more of ICTs if rural development has to take place.
With this note, thank you, sir. Thank you so very much. Dear friends, we believe that you might have learned the new perspective today, and information communication technology, this term has been has become very, very important for you, and you have understood how it is playing important role in our lives as well as in the rural development. Dear friends, if you have any queries or if you want to give your feedback for this particular lecture, then you can contact us at info.cc@nic.in. Your feedbacks are welcome. We would be meeting again soon and would be discussing on another topic. Till then, take care. Goodbye. Thank you, sir. Thank you once again.
Thank you very much.